Hey everyone, I'm Howard Pinsky, and in today's Adobe XD tip, we're going to take a look at creating fun and stylized page indicators to use within your onboarding experiences. Let's dive in. Here I have a few screens that I built out during an Adobe live stream, and I may want to add visual indicators to let users know which step they're on and how many there are. Starting off with the inactive dots, the ellipse tool can be used to create a perfect circle. Then I'll pull a color from the design, like this pink, and then pull the opacity back a touch to create an inactive feel. With one in place, the others can quickly be created by either duplicating them over manually or popping them into a repeat grid and dragging out as many as you need. And to add room for the animation to take place, they should be relatively spaced out from each other. Great, before moving on to the active dot, let me quickly name this grid. Alright, now you may be thinking, to make the process easier, you can copy one of the circles to use as the active indicator. And if you're not looking to stylize the animation, you can certainly do that. But to help when elongating takes place, we're going to be using a rectangle instead. Once it's been drawn out over top of one of the existing circles, the corners can be completely rounded to disguise it as an ellipse. Since this will be the element that indicates the active screen, I'll use the highlight color here. Now, a decision needs to be made. If you simply want the ellipse to move to its next location, you can pop these elements on each screen and shift the active dot over. But since we want to add a touch of fun to the interaction, let's move on. As you saw in the preview, when the transition takes place, the active indicator briefly expands and then contracts into place. To accomplish this, we need to get creative with masks. Here's what we're going to do. Since this mask will follow the same shape as the rounded rectangle, we can quickly duplicate it and then select both objects in the Layers panel. Once selected, under the Object menu on the Mac or right-clicking on an element on Windows, choose Mask with Shape. This will take the bottommost layers and mask them inside the shape at the top. Next, we need to extend the mask a touch. So, selecting the topmost layer, pull out the left edge about 4 times the size of the ellipse. Now, why are we doing this? In short, it'll allow us to temporarily stretch out the indicator during the transition. Now that the first position is complete, I'll quickly group these elements and then copy and paste them onto the second artboard, where I can now make the necessary changes. First, the mask group will be shifted over to line up over top of the second ellipse, and then we'll want to reverse the two elements within it. The visible shape will be pulled out, then the mask will be pulled back in to once again make up a perfect circle. Great. Finally, for the third screen, we can simply paste the first set of indicators and shift the active mask over to the final position. Alright, let's wire this up. Switching over to prototype mode, I'll select the button at the bottom and then drag the handle over to the second artboard. Within the Properties Inspector, we'll want to make sure that Tap is selected, then Auto Animate is the chosen action to ensure we have a nice smooth transition. For the easing options, In Out should look pretty nice, and to allow us to enjoy this animation, a duration of around 0.8 seconds will do the trick. I can then wire up the button on the second artboard leading to the third. Now, the moment of truth. Launching the preview window, clicking on the next button will kick off the transition and reveal our animation. And because of how our layers were set up, we're left with a fun look to our indicators. Before we wrap up, if you want to get even more stylized with the animation, on the second artboard, stretch out the visible shape within the mask quite a bit more than you originally did. And now when the prototype is previewed one more time, there's a slight windup before it shoots over to the right. And there you have it, a simple but fun interaction you can add to your onboarding flows. For more tips and tricks just like this, head on over to letsxd.com and I'll see you all soon.